everyone. I'm here today with Babyliss, and I'm going to be showing you how to recreate the Kate Middleton hairstyle, which has been requested so much by you guys on my channel. And I'm very lucky to have Stephen G, celebrity hairdresser, here with me today to help me along the way and give special hints and tips.
Thank you very much, Tanya. Now, you and a billion other girls around the world want to look like our Princess Kate.
It's yes, we do.
Yeah, exactly. It's one of the hardest looks to get on your own. I think most girls that have that glamorous, celebrity, perfect blow-dry have to go to a salon. Up until now, of course, because with a big hair, what you actually get is you get a big soft brush with a hairdryer built in. So you can actually blow dry your hair and get those really nice, big, natural, bouncy, shiny blow dries.
It is absolutely amazing, isn't it?
Yeah, well, we tried it a little bit earlier and you found it so simple. I just want to show everyone how easy this is to use.
Especially as I could never handle a massive hairdryer and a big round brush. Trying to use them together.
Yeah, most people find it really hard because either you've got to have massive muscles in your arm or you can do yoga and you tend to give up halfway through, don't you? And to get that kind of salon finish, you tend to have to go to a salon to get it done. Most of my clients, when I blow dry their hair, and then they say to me, well, I'm never going to get it to look like that. And you actually can. So I'm going to get you to section your hair.
Okay.
Just from ear to ear. Great. Now you can actually take quite big sections because it is quite a big soft brush. I'm going to show you the first section just to show you how easy this is. You actually have a couple of heat settings on this. So you have this heat setting with a slower spin and then you have a higher heat setting with a faster spin. So I'm going to actually go right in. Now the secret is to actually start with the brush spinning the minute you go in, and then work it through, like you see in the salon. That's exactly the kind of motion. So going straight in and running it through your hair, right in at the root, and then what you do is you let it grab the ends naturally and roll it up, hold it there for about 5 seconds, a couple of taps to release, and what you get is loads
of... Amazing lifter.
Yeah, loads of volume. And what you also get is that really nice little flick on the ends.
Which Kate Middleton always has, doesn't
she? Exactly. And the thing is, before, you know, when you've tried to do this on yourself, I think one of the main things is people try and, with some stylists, try and run it through their hair, where this actually does all the work for you. Do you want to have a go on the other side?
Yeah, I'd like to have a go.
Perfect. Couple of taps and then get the hair down.
Yeah.
Can you see already the volume you get?
Yeah.
But let's go over that section just one more time. And when you release, people do that all the time. Mm-hmm. But the thing is, it will never catch in your hair, so it doesn't matter if you go the wrong way. Perf it up and just give it a little release and then hold the hair. Oh, perfect. Okay. Look at the bounce. Look at that.
Yeah. Well, it's so pretty, doesn't it?
Well, already, that's taken how much hard work out of you actually having to stretch and strain.
Yeah.
Next section, it's really easy. Just go from your temple and then right back just to below your crown. Now, remember, this spins both ways, so if you're right-handed or left-handed, it makes it a lot easier for you to use. Perfect. So let's take... Right, go straight in, come on.
Okay.
You're already looking like a princess. And the great thing is you can actually work it. You see how you're working that straight through the hair?
Yeah.
Effortlessly. And then just work it up. And then just release.
It's so easy.
It's so easy. Now see when you release, just release it once, because it's such a soft brush, you can actually slide it right out of the hair. It won't tangle in the hair, it won't catch the hair.
Okay, so the next section will just be one bit back.
Yeah. And because it spins either clockwise and anti-clockwise, you can actually flick your hair out at the bottom if you wanted, or you can just get that really nice, smooth, almost straight blow dry if you just kept running it all the way through your hair. That's it. Perfect. Why do you think loads of your viewers want to know about the Kate Middleton kind of style?
Oh wow, that one worked out, didn't it?
Perfect.
I think because she looks great and she looks so polished and but pretty at the same time.
Yeah, really feminine and natural. Yeah. Do you want to try this side?
Yeah.
When you release it, don't carry on spinning. I'll just tap it and then let it come out naturally. So just give it one tap, one little tap, and then release it, and then take... That's it. Perfect. Look at that.
Yeah,
at
wow. Volume.
That's volume. But you see how you're getting those lovely flicks on the end as well?
Yeah, that's my favourite bit about the big hair, is the shape that it gives my ends, which you can't get when you're just blasting your hair with a hairdryer, which is what I used to do.
Well, you tend to find the girls want kind of that big hair look, but they necessarily don't want curls in their hair. They just want tiny bit of movement.
I don't necessarily want curls every day.
Now, you could actually blow dry your hair really, really straight with this as well. You wouldn't take it up to the root. You would just take it right to the ends, just to give you a really nice, voluminous, straight blow dry.
Yeah. Okay, let's try this a bit.
Okay, perfect. Now I just take the last drop, the last section down. Beautiful.
Where's the last section?
I would just drop this last section down. The whole thing with this is I want you to do this really, really easily. You know when hairdressers section your hair?
Yeah.
And they tend to take a lot of sections because they tend to use a smaller brush than this. Because this is quite a big brush, you can take quite large sections.
You can. It can deal with the large sections, can't it?
Now the great thing is we come to the fringe here. If you actually have a fringe, with this, you can just put it straight in and work the fringe to give a really nice voluminous fringe. You probably find that you don't get loads of volume.
Yeah, could it give me volume even on this
hair? Right, go
hair
straight
here.
In. I want you to go straight into your front section.
Okay.
Now, do you see how easily now that you're just going flicking your hair in?
It's so easy.
Let's have a look.
Whoa.
Do you see the lift already?
Yeah.
Right, I want you to try it on this side as well.
That's amazing. Okay.
Now, this is probably a real troublesome area for you because it's really hard for you to get the brush and the hairdryer and see what you're doing. Just hold it, release it gently. Beautiful. Now, do you see already the lift that you're getting at the front?
Yeah.
That's beautiful.
Amazing.
Let's go into this section now here. Now, see how quickly you've actually managed to work right the way through your whole head. Go straight to the ends. Perfect. And a little release. Now, do you know what you've done there automatically, which is brilliant? You lifted it really high up.
Yeah.
Which is how you're actually going to get masses of volume in the top of your hair. Let's do this side now. Turns, yeah, perfect. Beautiful.
Yeah, that's given me so much volume.
Look at the lift. Now, do you see the lift actually at the roots?
Yeah.
Now, another little tip, that if you're just going out and you can't be bothered to do the whole of your hair, that you just want the top to have a little bit of added volume, you can actually go right in. Do you remember how you were actually doing it earlier?
Yeah.
You can go right in the root. Rather than going all the way through your hair, you can just actually put it in at the root just to give a little bit of root lift if you wanted a quick... get out the door, finish on your hair without having to do the whole lot. Now,
I absolutely love that.
This is the nightmare section because it's the actual crown, which is really hard for you to do all of this
really
with your arms. Pick up this last section, just a small section. Just take that section and then do it to the side rather than going all the way back.
Rather than going back?
Yeah, because then you can actually flip it over once you're actually finished and you'll get that really nice bardo.
Okay, cool.
Okay? Perfect. And perfect, you're lifting up really high. So just release it a couple of taps. That's it. And then take it smooth out. And then what I would do now is just flip that back. And look already, you get loads of lift to your crown.
Yeah.
Now,
amazing.
If I was in the salon now, after I'd finished the blow dry, I would literally just put your head back, run your fingers through it, feel how silky your hair is.
Yeah.
And what that does is just break up your hair. Look how much volume. I'm not joking you. I don't know any hairdresser that could actually do this as brilliant a blow dry as that you've actually done. Did you actually think that you'd ever be able to do this on yourself?
No.
But look at this. I literally did not interfere with you. I was watching you do it and you were getting so confident at the end. You look fantastic.
It just has such amazing shape. It's what I love about it.
And shiny as well. Look how shiny and glossy.
And soft.
Yeah.
I love it. It's amazing.
You look great.
Thank you. So here we have the Kate Middleton blow dry look that was just so much easier than using a big round brush and a hairdryer. It's like all into one with the big hair. And it was just really, really easy to do. And you can really just kind of get your fingers in there, make it as big as you want or as smooth as you want. Like I quite like it a little bit bigger like that. And yeah, there we have it. Really easy. Thanks for watching, guys.